What we do is based on that Victorian idea of using engineering to change the world around us.
It's hard to believe that close to this idyllic area in the middle of England, the first industrial revolution began. These days, people here are working on the fourth industrial revolution.
Our ambition is to revolutionize manufacturing and the way that things are made, in the same way that someone like Apple changed the way that we think about phones.
It all started with a groundbreaking invention Steve Lindsey made in 2003. And he wasn't even an engineer. He was a chemist and business consultant, but above all, he was curious.
I read somewhere that 10% of electricity that's used by industry within Europe, across all industry, goes into compressors. It's a fantastically high figure. And I realized that if you could make a difference to that, you could potentially make a big difference to energy usage across Europe. Now, the last big change in compressors was the screw compressor in 1935, and there hasn't been any big changes since then.
He can't believe it. In almost 80 years, there hasn't been a new idea in this area. This is an enormous challenge for him to do exactly that, to invent a revolutionary new compressor.
I often go for long walks in nature, and then, in the quiet time, I can visualize things in 3D. It was the realization that you could have two interlinking but offset rings, which could then form a new geometry for a compressor. So as the blade, which is effectively the piston, rotates, draws in a volume of gas behind it, the magic bit is that as it passes through this disc, it catches up the volume of gas that it induced in the last cycle and is now compressing it. So a very, very simple device, but very efficient. Back in 2017, our goal was to develop technology, which we then licensed to a big company to manufacture and sell.
In 2017, Steve Lindsey was nominated for the European Inventor Award for his groundbreaking invention.
The awards were really important to us. They generated far more publicity than we expected and got a lot of people talking about us and asking, could we go a step further and actually manufacture ourselves?
And since Steve Lindsey loves to take on new challenges, he begins to build his own production facility.
This is really exciting because it gives us a lot more opportunities to improve, innovate, and patent. What we've done is taken a fresh look at the whole manufacturing process in the same way that we took a fresh look at compressors. It gives us a lot of opportunity to change the way things are made.
The first industrial revolution consisted of mechanization using water and steam power. The second was characterized by mass production using assembly lines and electric power. The third relied on electronics and IT to automate production. The fourth is based on intelligent, digitally networked systems. They are designed to enable holistic production, logistics, and maintenance. Networks and advanced data processing optimize the entire value chain.
And that's what we call a smart factory. More reliable, more productive, and more efficient. So we're taking the kind of thinking that's revolutionized the consumer world into industry. Like the fully integrated supply chains that are behind something like Amazon's one-click ordering, our ambition is that the industrial user will be able to buy things like warranties, products, and services in exactly the same kind of way.
Or maintenance, or uptime. An artificial intelligence algorithm on the machine learns how it operates and detects if something unusual is happening long before it becomes obvious.
It's like with your car, the machine telling you when it needs a service rather than when it's broken down. But more interestingly, the machine can tell you when it doesn't need a service. And that's really important in terms of saving energy and saving the environment.
But Steve Lindsey is looking at an even bigger picture. Because they built the machine with predictive maintenance and the Internet of Things in mind, they already have all this processing power at the heart of the manufacturing process.
It's only a small leap to think of our machine starting to optimize the processes and equipment around it. This is new, and taking this holistic approach allows you to reduce waste, reduce energy, and improve sustainability.
The LP2 will be the first Lontra manufactured and branded product, and it will go into production later this year.
On our current projections, just the first product will make Lontra a $500 million business, but this is just the beginning.
Steve Lindsey seems to have it made. Out of curiosity, a brilliant idea, and a strong patent, he created a successful company.
So my original compressor invention was a seed to grow a company, to take it to market and make a difference, not just to industry, but to sustainability as a whole. The really exciting thing is we're only just getting started.